Now we are going to discuss a very important thing, that is the behavior of resistive devices in AC circuit. How many elements are there which are basically offering resistance for the flow of current? One, you know, resistor is very well known. Another thing which you have understood is inductor, and third, you have also gone across capacitor. So there are three elements which always offers opposition to the flow of current in the circuit. However, their behavior of offering opposition to the flow of current is different. Everybody offers in different manner. This you can compare with three different types of the people in the society. Number one, people, type of the people which are always getting agitated whatever you say, even if you crack a joke, mazak bhi kar do tab bhi unhe gussa aa jata hai, they got heated. Dusri tarah ke log hote hain jo bada hi fluctuating hote hain, they got angry with a person this moment and next moment call back the person and saying sorry. This kind of behavior is of inductor. तीसरी तरह के लोग होते हैं जो बहुत मक्कार होते हैं. And these type of people, if they are in trouble, they go to many people and try to seek their advices, what to do and what is not to do, and finally they do whatever they have decided. So these types of the behavior is of capacitor. So what we are going to do here, we will analyze the presence of each element separately, and while putting each element separately in the circuit, we will check how much is the current flowing through it, how much is the resistance offered by this element in the AC circuit, and what is the phase difference between applied EMF and current. And after that, we will plot a phasor diagram. Right? So let's see pure resistor in AC circuit. First element, pure resistor in AC circuit. Consider a pure resistance of value R is connected across an alternating EMF source. E is equal to E naught sin omega t. So applied EMF is E is equal to E naught sin omega t. Current through resistor when you find, then I is equal to E over R, that is E naught over R sin omega t. This is maximum current. So no difference, behavior is same. If you look at the second resistance offered by the resistor in AC circuit is R, and it also offers same resistance with DC. So the first conclusion is resistance offered is R. Second thing, when we look at the phase difference, how do I find phase difference? First check in both the equations varying function is same or not. E is varying according to sine function, I is also varying according to sine function. If it is varying according to the same type of function, then you can take an argument, difference of the argument. Argument means angle attached with the sine. So it is omega t here, so phase difference is 0. Omega t minus omega t is 0. If these are of two different functions, then first bring both the equations in the same function and then take the difference of the argument. So conclusion, second conclusion is applied EMF and current are in same phase. applied EMF and current are in same phase. That is, phase difference is zero. So when you plot a phasor diagram, E naught is already having angle omega t. Since I naught is also having same angle, so on the same line you mark I naught also. This is the value of E naught, this is the value of I naught. This is called phasor diagram. Second, so what we have finally understood, that if resistor you place in AC circuit, it doesn't matter because its behavior remains same whether you place it in AC or DC circuit. It will offer resistance equal to R. Second is pure inductor in AC circuit. So consider a pure inductor of inductance L connected across an alternating EMF source E is equal to E naught sin omega t. So applied EMF is equal to E naught sin omega t 1, then induced EMF across inductor E is equal to L di over dt, right? This induced EMF must be equal to this because there is only one element present in AC circuit. So L di over dt is equal to E naught sin omega t. Why we are doing it? Because we need a equation for current. So di is equal to, you will have E naught over L sin omega t dt. How do I get the value of I by this equation? Integrating both the sides. So integrate both the sides. I is equal to, you will have E naught over omega L, and here minus cos omega t. Right? This you can write it as E naught over XL, and minus cos omega t you can write, minus I keep out, then sin pi by 2 minus omega t is cos omega t. So this equation is finally E naught over XL sin omega t minus pi by 2. Now what is a phase difference between applied EMF and current? Argument of EMF is omega t. Argument of sine here is omega t minus pi by 2. So when you subtract omega t minus omega t plus pi by 2, EMF and current argument difference is coming plus pi by 2. It means EMF is leading in phase pi by 2, or you can say current lags behind in phase pi by 2, right? And what is XL? XL is termed as inductive reactance. XL is termed as inductive reactance. Where XL is equal to omega L is equal to 2 pi nu L, this is called inductive reactance. Inductive reactance is what? Resistance offered by an inductor to the AC. So SI unit of this will be ohm. But you see a brilliant difference in these two things. Case for DC, direct current, frequency is not there. Its nu is zero. सो इट मींस XL इज जीरो. XL इज जीरो मींस इंडक्टर कॉइल डज नॉट ऑफर एनी रेजिस्टेंस टू द फ्लो ऑफ डीसी. इंडक्टर, प्योर इंडक्टर डज नॉट ऑफर एनी रेजिस्टेंस टू द फ्लो ऑफ एसी डीसी सॉरी. हाउएवर फॉर एसी न्यू ऑलवेज हैव सम फाइनाइट वैल्यू. सो एक्सएल इज फाइनाइट, इट ऑफर्स रेजिस्टेंस, offers resistance to AC. You can easily see the dual nature of inductor. How resistance does not show any dual nature. Here it offers resistance to the AC, it doesn't offer resistance to the DC. Now XL is varying according to frequency as linearly. So when you plot a graph between XL and frequency, it will be a straight line. And the slope of curve, 10 theta, will measure to pi L. This question of the graph has been asked so many times in the CBSE examination. Very frequently asked. Right? Now, second conclusion is, applied EMF leads in phase to current by phase pi by 2. So you need to plot phasor diagram also. So plot phasor diagram. E naught will be here, angle is omega t. EMF leads, so current lags. I naught will be here, clockwise direction always. This is pi by 2. Right? So we have learned behavior of an inductor and behavior of resistor, and behavior of resistor is found very surprising. Behavior of inductor is found very surprising that it is showing double nature, right? Next is pure capacitor in AC circuit. So let's see pure capacitor in AC circuit. So consider a capacitor of capacitance C connected across an alternating EMF source. E is equal to E naught sin omega t. So applied EMF is this, then potential difference across capacitor, you know formula, V is equal to Q over C, therefore these two will be same, Q over C is equal to E naught sin omega t, this stands as Q is equal to C E naught sin omega t. So we have got an equation for charge. But what do we need? We need an equation of current. So differentiating this with respect to t, you will get I is equal to dq over dt. This is equation 3. So I is equal to omega C ई नॉट कॉस ओमेगा टी, दिस ऑफ कोर्स वी कैन राइट ई नॉट ओवर वन ओवर ओमेगा सी साइन ओमेगा टी प्लस पाई बाई टू. सो आई इज इक्वल टू ई नॉट ओवर एक्स सी साइन ओमेगा टी प्लस पाई बाई टू. फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन यू कैन अगेन मेक इट आउट सेम कंक्लूजन. एक्स सी इज लाइक इन इंडक्टर, एक्स सी इज कॉल्ड कैपेसिटिव रिएक्टेंस एंड इट्स वैल्यू इज वन ओवर ओमेगा सी, राइट. अगेन इट मेजर्स द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफर्ड बाय कैपेसिटर टू द एसी सर्किट. सो फॉर डीसी न्यू इज इक्वल टू जीरो, एक्स सी इज इक्वल टू इनफाइनाइट. फॉर डायरेक्ट करंट कैपेसिटर ऑफर्स इनफाइनाइटली लार्ज रेजिस्टेंस, रिमेंबर. सो सर्किट बिहेव्स एज ओपन सर्किट, नो करंट फ्लोस. इट मीन्स अ कैपेसिटर इज अ रियल ब्लॉकेज फॉर डीसी. इट डज नॉट अलाउ डीसी टू पास थ्रू इट. फॉर एसी न्यू इज फाइनाइट, देन एक्स सी इज ऑल्सो फाइनाइट. इट ऑफर्स रेजिस्टेंस टू द फ्लो ऑफ ऑल्टरनेटिंग करंट बट इट डजंट अलाउ डीसी टू पास थ्रू इट. However, you have seen in case of inductor, inductor allows DC to pass through it smoothly without any resistance. And here it doesn't allow DC to pass. Right? When you plot a graph, XC is varying reciprocal to the frequency. So the graph between XC and frequency will be 1 over x graph. Now, if we look at the phase difference, EMF leads in lags behind in phase because you are getting plus pi by 2. So, conclusion 2 is EMF lags behind in phase by pi by 2. So this difference of the angle will be anti-clockwise. So when you plot a phasor diagram again, E naught position is not changing, it is at omega t and this will be at I naught. Pi by 2. Right? That's what about three different types of the element behave in AC conductor.